nothing like a warm spring shower, is there? It kind of freshens up everything. Certainly reminds me of when I was on holiday in southern Italy, sitting down there on the side of the street there in Calabria, a place called Maratea, drinking a glass of wine and eating a plate of crispy calamari. And I got the recipe. I'm going to share that with you now. Now, very, very simple. Now, what we've got to do is I'm going to add about 6 ounces, 175 grams, of self-raising flour. And I know I'm just shaking it in. You can weigh it out if you want. And to that, I'm going to sprinkle in a little bit of salt and then a teaspoon of paprika. So I thought paprika's nice. It also gives it that lovely colour too. That's it. And then to that, we're going to add 8 fluid ounces, or if you like, 250 millilitres of cold water, that is. That's it. Just create a little well in the middle there. Pour some of that water in, about a third of it, and then just stir that round and keep stirring that. That's it. There we are. That's it. And you can see that's thickening up. And what you're looking for me, is a kind of a, it's like a heavy double sort of cream consistency, of course. Just let that rest a little bit. Now, I've got some squid here. I'll just cling film that up because I didn't want all those smells of the fish to kind of linger out all through your fridge there. That often happens, doesn't it? Now, squids, look at these. Look at that tube. Isn't that a wonderful tube there? Yeah, hello, how you doing? Hello, hello, hello. And you just cut that into strips, and if you can see here, that little crunch at the back there, that means that little bit of cartilage. Sometimes you get that in the corner. That comes in lots of different shapes, all these little sort of bits there. It looks like something you get in a, with toys, isn't it? One of those little plastic things. And then we're just going to cut those, the rest of that, into strips. Very, very simple. And with regards to the slightly smaller ones, you can also cut those in rings, but just cut that a little bit on the angle there. And then you've got these little bits here with the tentacles. And right at the end there, you've got a plastic bit called the beak, which you can just snap off like that. There you go. Perfect. A couple of tablespoons of flour. Just sprinkle it like that. And slightly sort of toss it using your fingers. Pop those straight into your batter. Just give that a bit of a shake. A bit like Giorgio there, isn't it? Talking about the waves of the sea in his risotto. Delightful. I like to the idea of using my tongs here. That really does help when you want to sort of pick up your piece of calamari and plunge them into your fryer. A little bit of control movement there. That's it. Look at those, lovely. Straight in there. There we are. It's like I'm working in a chippy here. And just let those cook away. That won't take very long. And that's literally going to take about 3 or 4 minutes. I've got some lovely fresh limes and lemons over here. And what I do is I cut the cheeks off these. All right, so it's about there. Do you see what I mean about that? Little cheeks. There we are. I think they're about ready to come out now. There. That's fantastic. And look at those. Aren't they lovely? Let's give that a little bit of a shake. Give that a little bit of a tap. And look at that. That all comes off. And that is perfect. That's okay. And just sort of stack those up, pile those up in a nonchalant way like that. There we are. And then serve that with the little wedges of lemons and limes. I think that's just fantastic like that. Just look at that. Isn't that great? Beautiful.